r/AskReddit. What is a childish thing you still do while being an adult? My wife and I took our first trip without our kids in over a decade. For the first day, I did what a normal adult would do and jumped in the pool, swam around a bit, then sat on the deck chairs, rinse, and repeat. By day 2, I got bored of this. I bought a pair of goggles, grabbed a quarter, and played that game where you throw the quarter into the pool and then swim underwater to find it. Just as fun as I remember it being when I was a kid. Oh no, I feel like I missed out. It's not too late. They're having a quarter life crisis. During autumn, I go out of my way to shuffle through piles of leaves when I'm walking. Step on the crunchiest of leaves. Young man, there are leaves all around. I said, young man, eat a leaf off the ground. I said, young man, won't it make a cool sound when you stuff it in your leaf hole? It's fun to chew on the leaves off the ground. What has happened to my sense of humor? I just sat and chuckled for a good 20 minutes and I can't tell if it's cause I'm really happy or really sad. I still run and hop onto the shopping cart through the aisles and parking lot. I stopped doing it after I stair toppling the cart. Being tall is not that great. I'm 6 feet 2 and wait till it's at least partially full so I don't end up on my ass again. The ride through the lot is downhill and a blast. I'm also 6 feet 2, and I hang my upper body over the basket part of my cart to keep the center of mass over the wheelbase. My dad is 75 and does this all of the time. Run upstairs on all fours. Yes, the old 4x4. Do you have 16 limbs? Don't you? The other night my boyfriend and I had a contest in our kitchen living room to see who could slide the furthest in our socks. We grabbed multiple different pairs to test which slid the best, and used tape to mark our furthest distance. We are both 32. I highly recommend it. This reminds me of a time when my husband and I were first married. We had no money to go out and we had an apartment with all wood floors. So one night we put on sweatpants and hoodies and took turns pulling each other around on the floor. It was a great time. My wife and I lived in a 3-bedroom apartment with 2 other people when we first started dating. In a rare occurrence, there was one night where we were going to be the only people in the apartment the whole night. We had the apartment to ourselves. A dream come true. What did we do, you ask? Do what adult people who are dating when left alone do? Nope, not at all. We found soundtracks for my wife to run down the hallway with a blanket tied around her neck to burst into the living room at full sprint and then immediately strike a superhero pose. You haven't lived until you see the love of your life running full book with a Star Wars blanket for a cape down a hallway to the sounds of Flash by Queen. She is the defender of the universe. I love that woman. Carry my umbrella like a sword. Correction. Carrying anything sword like a sword. Ride airwaves with my hands when in the car. My hand is a dolphin. I live in a really small town and everyone always waves back. But I'm not waving at them. I am the wave. Sitting on the floor. If I stay too long it's hard to get up and I have to stretch or risk a cramp, but there's something comforting to me about sitting on the floor. I'll come home sometimes to my wife on the floor in the kitchen just browsing through Reddit and eating random shit like a huge bowl of mashed potatoes. She's so cute sometimes. I like how your username is Pervy Potato. Seems like it's a theme in your life. Well, I did think she was pretty sexy while eating those potatoes. I think she is anyways, even when she has a massive hangover and morning dragon breath though. Woman shrugging. I do this as well. We recently moved into a new house. And unlike our previous house, this house is perfect for floor sitting. For some reason, there are houses that you simply cannot sit on the floor in. I can't explain why. Thinking face. I run up my basement stairs still afraid of something coming to get me. By chance, does anyone force themselves to go up slowly as an adult despite the impending doom you feel behind you? I do that. But it never gets easier. Speed doesn't matter, but if you turn around, you have to sprint. And it's probably too late. Me too. Doesn't matter whose house. Everyone has a killer in their basement waiting to grab me when I go upstairs. But he'll stop chasing you as soon as you get to the top of the steps and close the door. I just bought a giant stuffed shark from IKEA and named it Meatball and fall asleep cuddling it often. My boyfriend goes to work before I get up and will hand it to me before kissing me bye. I bought a giant teddy bear from IKEA for this very purpose. One of my better IKEA purchases. That. I bought the stuffed cactus from IKEA and my wife rolls her eyes whenever I tell her to make sure it gets plenty of sun. I love that cactus. Holy shit. It's only $18. I don't need it. I don't need. I don't need. I need it. You definitely need it, but be prepared to stand in front of the basket that they're in for about 20 minutes trying to choose the right one. Colon. Drawing on a steamed up window mirror. I like to do penguins. You shouldn't do that to penguins. It's actually okay. Just make sure you get consent next time. My husband drew a clown's face on the bathroom mirror shortly after I had gone to see it. The damn thing stayed there for months. Despite multiple cleanings, I finally got rid of it, but I'm still afraid it's going to show up on some other reflective surface someday. I slept holding a teddy bear as a kid, like for a long time. It just felt comfortable to cuddle with something in my arm. I don't have a teddy bear anymore, but I still do it with a pillow. Body pillows are amazing. My girlfriend made fun of me when she found out I sleep with two. One for both sides. She even bought me a Wadamaka body pillow cover. I was dumped a few months ago and I'm still pretty bummed about it. One of the first nights after, I found my favorite childhood stuffy I've had since I was a few months old, and I'll admit I held it all night while crying myself to sleep. It's still in my bed, and when I'm feeling particularly sad I'll cuddle it. Open automatic doors with the force and a little Jedi wave. Walked past a restaurant employee on the sidewalk doing this with some automatic windows. When our eyes met, he smiled and said, "With great power comes great responsibility. I want to be just like him when I grow up." Duck in Spider-Man and Star Wars mixed references. Shit, man. Make a giant leap from my light to my bed at night. Still scared of a monster popping up behind me. Get the clapper to turn off your light after you get in bed. You can be childish and senior citizenish simultaneously. I love how they still play the same exact commercial today as they have since the 80s. And always around Christmas. Talk to myself as if I had a whole bunch of crazy fictional friends. I do this all the time. My only real friends are imaginary. I have imaginary conversations with my real friends and imagine conversations as if they happen differently. When I take my nephew and niece to the playground, I don't stand and watch with the other parents. I jump in and play too. I do this and other parents just stare at me like I'm crazy, lol. Live a little. Word. My boyfriend and I have three kids between us and raced them up and down the slides while the other parents just gawked and guffawed. We had a blast. And I like to believe our kids will cherish those memories, you know? But if they don't, I have the satisfaction of knowing I beat him. I was a toddler when I met my stepmom for the first time and I still, vaguely, remember her playing in the McDonald's playground with us and thinking she was so cool for that. So who knows, they very well could. When I am riding passenger in the car I still imagine a little man running along the telephone lines. How is this so universal? I did something similar. I would pretend that I was riding a dirt bike on the side of the road, getting massive air on bridges. I am a badass on an imaginary dirt bike. My wife and I just moved to a rural area from a big city and we always yell, "Look, deer, cows, horses, goats." I'm not sure if this is childish, but I feel like it's a sense of wonderment that children have. Still do this, too, except we call them by their noises, so a cow is a moo. We drove the ring road in Iceland and there was this permanently erect horse that was a landmark we passed every day. Call him Mr. Longschlong. I still stick out my tongue when I'm writing something or concentrating on something intricate. My wife makes fun of me incessantly for it, but it works. Just tell her you're practicing your tongue muscles for other endeavors. Dot. Like licking envelopes closed. I still sleep with a stuffed animal on most nights. It's actually been scientifically tested that snuggling a stuffed animal helps you get a better sleep each night. Tell my brain that. Sometimes when I'm driving through a parking garage I make stupid race car sounds and pretend I'm firing missiles everywhere. I thought it was required to do this. I still buy children cereal. Also, Have you ever eaten an entire box of Cinnamon Toast Crunch for breakfast, lunch and dinner? Me either. Nope, never done that. Whistles. Do you eat Cinnamon Toast Crunch dry with a glass of milk on the side? Nah, me neither. That's just crazy. Eat ice cream for breakfast because now I duck I can. Well, you can as a child too. It just involved more sneaking. I save worms I see in puddles on the sidewalk after it rains, so they don't dry out and die when everything dries out. I toss them on the grass. I don't know if it helps them, but I try. Can we take a moment to reflect on that? You interpreted childishness as caring enough for a smaller life form to potentially better its chances at survival? My habit of greeting everyone I see is deemed childish by my older co-workers. Just because everyone wearing scrubs isn't a doctor does not mean I can't call them doctor. Not quite an adult yet, but I still focus on marks on the car window and bob my head up and down to make it jump over trees and buildings. Same. But it gets a lot harder when you have to drive at the same time. You're an adult now. No more easy child games. Swing on the swings at the playground, and occasionally jump out of them. Nothing. I'm not saying this to be contrary. I seriously thought about this question for a little while. I'm not proud of my answer. The weight of adulthood has probably pressed all fun and childish ways out of me. I'm going to see if I can take some cues from other commenters in this thread. Did you have a lot of childish ways before? I am in a similar boat, but I was pretty much a stick in the mud forever. Still need to watch Futurama or old Simpsons episodes to wind down before sleep. I can literally quote every line, but somehow my brain is still comforted with it playing in the background. Sleep with a teddy bear. I'm 28 and don't see a point in stopping. Otherwise I clench up my arms and they'll hurt the next day. So I use my bear, who's become a perfectly molded pillow over all the years. Luckily my husband doesn't think it's weird, I guess. My fiance and I have matching stuffed rabbits. I'm 26, he's 27. We got them just before Easter 5 years ago. Originally we only got one for me, but then he was jealous and wanted one too. They travel with us, and when he has work trips I send my rabbit with him and snuggle his one instead. On the rare occasions that we have to be without them, I wake up with my arm wrapped around a huge chunk of blanket and a cold and grumpy fiance. Watch old school cartoons while eating sugary cereal on my days off. Amazon Prime was worth it just for that alone. Still GTFO of my basement after I've turned the last light off just in case any creepy monsters were waiting to chase me. I still close my closet door every night just in case. My 53-year-old mother and I play tag in public occasionally when we are waiting for something. Airports and such. I eat spaghettios on a semi-regular occasion. They're tasty and if you add cheese, hot sauce, other things to it, they're damn good. Also, not really childish, but been doing it since I was younger when the LOTR movies came out. When I come up to a set of large wooden doors, I pretend I'm Aragorn entering Helm's Deep by leaning forward and opening them really dramatically. The ones at Dong's are especially good for it. Up your butt and around the corner. Every time it spills out of my mouth, I want to kick my own ass. I love color in my clothing but have no sense of fashion. I still dress like a child would pick my clothes. All color but nothing matches really. I feel dull and sad when I have to dress properly for work. You could try a bold color slash pattern on one piece of clothing and a neutral piece to pair. Super fun shirt with black pants for example. Or bold pattern shirt with a solid color pant in a single color pulled from the shirt. Watching SpongeBob. I just can't stop. Send help. PLZ. Putting my finger to block the hole of the straw of my drink so that the water does not flow out while drinking from the other end of the straw. I just don't know how to explain LOL. I have a special spoon that no one can use except me and regularly watch Disney cartoons with my family. I'm 25. When I'm walking and happen to be in an area with uneven colored tilings, I choose a color and try to avoid the other color. My co-workers and I prank each other. If someone's away from their workstation, the others will hide something there then make simply hint at it when that person come back. I recently had something taped to my light and they kept saying things like, "Could you shine some light on this situation?" then smirk till I caught on and found it. I've actually picked up a lot more childish things as I've grown older because I was this weird religious kid growing up who didn't enjoy anything except video games and reading. I'm much less of a square now, but I still stick around at home all day when not at work. Nowadays I am easily amused by dumb jokes, and often make food that would be 200% comfort food by indulging my inner child. I wrapped a burger with bacon the other day because I could, and then put cream cheese on it because it was delicious. I also sleep under like 5 fluffy blankets just because I love soft things and can tolerate being occasionally too warm at night. It's like all the things you want to do as a kid are more possible now that you're an adult. So why not do them? I grab my skirt tail and wave it. I've been doing it since I was a toddler. I skip. I twirl. I didn't know people had stopped somersaulting and cartwheeling until a few years ago. I thought most people kept doing these things. I watch cartoons all the time. I watch cartoons while I work. Right now Zootopia, Yellow Submarine, and Spirited Away DVDs are sitting on the desk, ready to play when my break is over. Eat way too much candy and not enough vegetables. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.